Good morning, South. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance with members of the GSA.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hear more from them later in the show. Good morning once again, and welcome to the Falcon Report for this Friday, the 11th of February, 2022, day two. I'm Nia Adlam.
And I'm Luke Williams. Last week, South's athletic atmosphere participated in the Student Athletic Conference. Isada Opom has the details.
South's athletes had the chance to participate in the Positive Coaching Alliance Leadership Conference to develop necessary skills to become better captains. Mr. Koskowitz messaged the coaches of South sports teams for the students' names.
I sent out an email to all the coaches, nominated a few people, we discussed it, and we came up with six outstanding candidates this year.
Those athletes were then placed into a classroom where they attended various Zoom calls and breakout conferences.
Don't tap out, right? You gotta stay at it, keep communicating with each other.
They spoke about their struggles with coaches and other athletes along Nassau County.
We don't talk too much about this, but what you're trying to do is create cultures on your team, right? This is the way that we do things here.
Following this enlightening experience, these athletes will go on to use their newly gathered knowledge on leadership to guide the South community and become even more positive and influential role models. An exceptional experience for South's athletes. For the Falcon Report, I'm Isada Opom.
Students in Mr. Lacordaire's 9th grade science classes recently conducted an exciting rock and mineral lab. To start, 10 mystery minerals are put in front of the students. To figure out the identity of the rocks, students scratch the minerals on porcelain to see the marks and evidence left, along with scratching the rocks on glass to find the density. Students then looked at the colors and lusters of each mineral to decide what they finally classified as. After repeating this process for all 10 minerals, students ended the experiment off by using their newfound knowledge to answer reflection questions and define keywords. Definitely an enjoyable and interactive way to end off an exciting unit.
Students in Ms. Elena Garces' Living Environment class recently learned about the biological agents. Starting the class off in a scientific manner, students were given a setup of three cups, two controls, but one that was filled with a pink chemical resembling an HPV sample. As the class tried to guess which cups were infected, they were tasked with creating bar graphs that represented the amount of people infected originally and at the end. With the lab coming to a close, each student had learned the attributes of HPV, including how fast it spreads and its dangerous effects.
February 11th marks P.S. I Love You Day, and South GSA is ready.
We join now with Emily Nofterth, who had a chance to talk with many members of the club.
Emily?
I'm joined here now with some of the members of and the advisor of South's GSA to hear about the upcoming P.S. I Love You Day. So what exactly is P.S. I Love You Day?
So P.S. I Love You Day is something that started in West Islip, Long Island, which is a town in Suffolk County, by a student there whose father unfortunately died by suicide, and she wanted to spread awareness about mental health issues and concerns along with something that would represent love and relationships and how we can be more kind to each other.
And how and when will South be participating in this?
So we're going to be participating starting on February 14th, which happens to be Valentine's Day, and we will be challenging everybody in our school to participate in the P.S. I Love You Challenge. Each day there will be a different challenge. They will be posted around the building, starting with things that are simple in terms of kindness and opening a door for somebody. We are going to have hearts available where you can fill out a kind message and give it out to any type of friends. At the end of the week, we're going to be wearing purple and showing support to mental health awareness.
Why do you think it's important for South students to participate in these activities?
Oh, that's a really good question. So I think that South should participate in all these activities because it would just help a lot of people, you know? I think bettering others' mental health, whether it be your friends or maybe even some that you don't know, it could really go a long way and maybe like advise them going to the wellness center that happens on Tuesdays.
I feel that South students should participate because just, you know, saying a nice compliment to somebody or just saying like you like their outfit or something could really bring up their day. You never know how your words can really change how somebody feels.
Well, thank you both so much for joining us. Back to you.
When the Falcon Report returns, we'll learn more about the compelling English arguments, but first, a bird's eye view of South's indoor track team. The Falcon Report will be right back.
Where's all that noise coming from?
That's kind of a little close.
Yeah. You forgot your stuff.
What?
Oh! Why do I have Born Barry alive?
I can't wait for the pretzel sale after school.
Me too.
Wait, pretzel sale? I need a pretzel!
I'll have one pretzel, please.
That'll be $1, sir.
Here you go.
Hey, you over there. Yes, you. Are you interested in the law? Do you want to meet a judge and some other qualified professionals who can help you to further your career goals? Well, now you can. The History Honor Society will be hosting an event in which you can meet a judge and ask any questions. Come to the library on the 17th after school or talk to HHS for more information.
Some fierce debate in English classes last week. Matthew Campbell has the story.
The students of Ms. Katie Maltz's and Mr. Michael Florio's English A classes held a topical debate throughout last week. The topic of the debate, binge-watching your favorite shows. After choosing their side, the students wrote compelling argument essays and were paired into teams based on their chosen stance. Following this, yet another article was introduced to the class in order to provide an opportunity to see the various pros and cons of the issue of binge-watching. This would then be dissected by students to be used as strong evidence, paired with the use of ethos, pathos, and logos, in order to convince the audience to support their side. This wasn't done in a casual fashion, however. Students came prepared as if coming to defend their case in court. Having memorized their parts, the young lawyers dressed up formally and engaged in a final, official debate to settle the issue. For sure, a tricky issue to tackle. For the Falcon Report, I'm Matthew Campbell.
Temperatures have been warming up this week.
I really hope that continues from the weekend, but Lauren Fraser will know for sure.
Lauren?
This weekend will have just a bit more warm weather than a major change. Today will be in the mid-40s and it will also be mostly sunny. Expect tomorrow to go all the way up to 54 degrees with a breeze and a mix of clouds. Sunday will not be more of the same. The temperature will take a dip to freezing and even a bit of snow. It will drop even further into Monday. So enjoy the start of the weekend, South. Back to you.
South's track and wrestling team has recently seen multiple successes.
Alina Trzynski is here to tell it all.
Alina?
Thanks, guys. The winter track team had their county meet to start off the week. For the boys' track team, Jaden Sampson ran the 1,000. The race started with Sampson pulling ahead of all the runners except for North Shore. As the race continued, the two of them would keep up with each other, not letting the other pass through. As they were in the last lap of the race, North Shore got ahead, but Sampson wouldn't let him and at the last turn beat him, earning him all county. The 4x4 was an effort by Jason Gutierrez, Joshua Osei, Jaden Sampson, and Julian Woodley. The boys put on a good race, earning them all county honors. On the girls' side, the 4x4 was ran by seniors Gabby Burry and Nia Anjo, and juniors Melissa Gay and Tori Daniels. The girls ran an incredible race, which earned them all counties. Over the weekend, Aiden Mitchell competed with the wrestlers at Belmore JFK in order to go to counties. The county qualifiers were Saturday for the wrestling team, and South saw some success. Aiden Mitchell was in the 215-pound weight class at the county qualifying meet. He earned all-conference at the meet, which secured him a spot in the NASA County Championships at NASA Community College this weekend. Aiden Mitchell had only one loss, which he followed with three straight wins as he placed fourth overall. And that's sports.
That's all for this edition of the Falcon Report. For Nia Adlam, I'm Luke Williams.
Have a great weekend, South.